Hi there. Up until now, we have been solving all kinds of equations. As we have seen, solving an equation amounts to the question, given two functions, for what inputs are they equal? But there are also situations in which you do not want to set two functions equal, but rather compare them. For what input is the one function larger than the other? For example, think of a jet that follows some curved path. If you know a function describing the path, you can calculate the g-forces that act on the pilot as a function of time. The g-forces should not be too high, at least not for too long, otherwise the pilot may lose consciousness. We should check at what times the g-forces exceed the safety threshold. This comes down to solving an inequality. Before we turn to solving inequalities, let me review the terminology and notation. There are several inequality signs that you should know. This first expression means that A is greater than B and not equal to B. If you reverse the inequality sign, it simply means that A is less than B and not equal to B. These inequalities are also called strict inequalities. If A and B are allowed to be equal, we denote this as follows. The first notation means A is greater than or equal to B. The second means that A is less than or equal to B. Instead of less and greater, also smaller and larger are used. Having established this, we now turn to the question how to solve inequalities between functions. To make the story clearer, let's look at an illustrative example. Take the following inequality, x smaller than or equal to 4 over x. For what values of x is it satisfied? Before I tell you how to solve such an inequality, let me show you the graphs. The inequality amounts to the following question. For which x values does the green line lie above the blue one? The graph suggests that there are two intervals on which the inequality is satisfied. One unbounded interval on the left and one bounded interval. These two intervals form the solution set of the inequality. For values of x outside the set, the inequality does not hold. Now, it is important to note the following. The boundaries of the intervals are either marked by a point where both sides of the inequality are equal, or by a point where a domain problem occurs. So, to describe the solution set, we have to find these points. First, let us look at the x values where both sides are equal. That is, we solve the equation x equal to 4 over x. To get rid of the denominator, multiply both sides by x. We then obtain x squared equal to 4. This has two solutions, x equal to 2 or x equal to minus 2. You can easily check that both are indeed solutions to the equation. So, equality holds for x equal to 2 and x equal to minus 2. Now, we need to find x values where domain problems occur. This only happens at x equal to 0, since 4 over x is not defined there. The three points that we have found divide the real line into four intervals. Now the following is important. On each interval, the inequality holds either for all values of x or for no values of x, except possibly at the boundary points. So to check on each interval whether the inequality holds, it suffices to look at one point. For example, in the left interval, we can try x equal to minus 4. You see that indeed the inequality holds. Therefore, it holds on the whole interval. In the next interval, we can try x equal to minus 1 and see that there the inequality does not hold. So, it does not hold on the second interval. We can continue in this way. Finally, we have to check the boundary points of the intervals. At x equal to 2 and x equal to minus 2, the inequality is indeed satisfied. At x equal to 0, the inequality is not satisfied, since the right-hand side is not defined there. We can now gather all the results to find the solutions. This inequality is satisfied for x smaller than or equal to minus 2, and x between 0 and 2, including 2, but excluding 0. The solution set can also be described in terms of intervals. Be aware that several ways of notation exist, but it is common to use a round bracket if the boundary is not part of the interval and a square bracket if it is. The U-shaped symbol in the middle indicates that we take a union. The example illustrates the general method. Suppose you want to solve an inequality. Then, first, find the x values where the functions are equal and the points where one of the functions is not defined or has a discontinuity. At such points, the inequality can change from valid to invalid. These points divide the real line into intervals. Look at each interval whether the inequality holds. You can check this at one point in the interval. Finally, check at each boundary point whether the inequality holds. The solution is then the union of intervals on which the inequality holds. You may wonder what happened to the simplify, solve, check strategy that we used for solving equations. Well, the main method to simplify an equation is to apply the same operation on both sides. If you do that to an equation, it remains valid. However, for an inequality, this can be quite tricky. For example, 1 is smaller than 2. If you square both sides, it remains true. On the other hand, minus 3 is also smaller than 2, but minus 3 squared is not smaller than 2 squared. To avoid tricky problems like this, you can always use the procedure outlined in this video. Try it in the exercises.